you should know they are the human bioelectricity. And it is very wonderful. So may mga doctor po, gumagamit po ng panggagamba through electrification, but on a standard basis and regulated. But because of rampant microwave, radiation wave, electrical wave, from wire, that today is all wireless. This body that you and I have are exposed to that of this electrification of the body. We call it ionizing radiation and the non-ionizing radiation that supplying all everything like the TV station network, the radio, the X-ray, and many others, including the cell phone, the microwaves. You see, X-ray is on the category of ionizing. And all of them are frequencies from kilohertz to megahertz to gigahertz. So, palaki ng palaki yung signal wave. Ito po yung mga dangerous. Ito, dangerous ito, pero this is the most dangerous. This is also dangerous. So, let's look on the X-ray. In the X-ray, once you are being exposed to X-ray, the radioactive from the X-ray damage your chromosomes to promote cancer cells leading to the to growth and development of tumor. Lahat po tayo pag binulatan ng X-ray dito sa dibdib, masisira po yung chromosomes. Kaya yung doktor, nagpe-prescribe sa inyo ng nutrient, sustansya. Hindi mo na-imagine yan. Once you went to the hospital, exposed ka sa mga radioactivity in the hospital, like X-ray, MRI, cardiogram, imaging technology or scanning method, ang doktor po responsible to prescribe nutrient. But sad to say, they prescribe the OTC of the drugstore, over-the-counter nutrient, which is synthetic also made. Okay? So how can you be repaired? So yung method na, I recommend not to put yourself on X-ray because your system is very low. Kung siguro bata ka pa, pwede. But today, the most special concern is about the very big damaging effect of cell phone radiation. The Bluetooth, the internet, there are what we call it, destroying the position of your the negative and the positive charge in your brain due to the effect of this destroyer of your chromosomes, beginning from X-ray trap to cell phone trap, the heavy ion trap. This is the cell phone and this is the X-ray. The X-ray is only this the damage, but in the cell phone, trader po ang malaking signal ang pumapasok sa iyong utak at sa iyong katawan to destroy your immune system. So yun po yung mga scenario ngayon na dapat malaman natin. Then it leads to promoting cancer cells. Ionizing radiation from X-ray, ang non-ionizing is for the cell phone, which is the most dangerous. But X-ray is dangerous, so let's talk about the X-ray. In X-ray, ionizing radiation use uranium atoms, breaking into smaller atoms and particles which enter a human cells and striking the nucleus and damage the DNA, causing it to divide in uncontrolled way, leading to cancer. Wala pa na si. Okay? Yun po yun. So, in X-ray, you develop cancer if your body cannot be repaired or unrepairable. This is the effect of direct heat from radioactivity through from cell phone or any part of the global Wi-Fi. This is your chromosomes. The direct heat is tatama sa iyong laman, sa brain, the tissue, sa iyong 100 trillion cells, surrounded by paranormal wave or electromagnetic frequencies. This is the radiation trap that damage your DNA, cluster DNA damage, you see? And this is your chromosomes. Yan, ganyan po siya. Direct hit, para kang binaril. Now, once you hold your cell phone, para kang binabaril dito, hindi mo napapansin na sisira yung consciousness mo. nakababad ka, lalo ngayon ang promotion nila. Ang likod, di ba? Kung ano ng mga promo. Sirong ka ba? Ang mamayan. And that is what we call it, direct route. Ang iniinom ng tubig sa labas ay may mga free radical. Don't tell me they are alkaline, pine. All of them are indirect route because everything outside the body are all irradiated. Mga pagkain, ninong, whether soft drinks or tubig. Okay? So, kailangan ang tubig mo ay protected na protected, silyado. Pagbukas mo, inampagad. Eh, binibili mo sa radio station. Lahat po yan, may radioactivity because of the global Wi-Fi. And that is what we call it, indirect route. The water you drink may form the free radical and you drink it. So, your body will be damaged. And this is the cell phone. Your body will be damaged. So, double damage yan. Okay? Nakintindihan yun?
Yes.
Promoting DNA damage. This is the DNA damage of stage 1, 2, 3. Yan po yun. In America, ewan ko meron dito, the scanning of DNA is through what we call it comet assay. Comet. Parang kometa na may buntot. Ang tawag po dito sa mga medical specialists ko to read the aggravation of DNA damage, they call it the nucleus of the damage. And this puntot, they call it tail moment. The longer the tail, no, the aggravation is very bad. And this is the stage 4. Yun. Wala. Pag namatay ang DNA, patay ang may-ari ng DNA. Gusto nyo ba ang ganun? Walang magtuturo niyan sa ospital dahil makakapag-ingat ka. Ang kailangan siguro nila, may sakit ka. Eh kung wala nang papasok sa ospital, doktor ang tinuturo ako. Ang kayong doktor sa akin nagpapagamot. Ang doktor sa akin nagpapagamot. Hindi ang doktor nagpapagamot sa kapa ng doktor. Pag nagpagamot ang doktor sa kapa, MD, patay ang MD. Nakon yung point on?
Yes.
Yun yun. Kasi kailangan nila yun eh. Kaya na yung mga stage 4, nasan sila? Makatimid, patay. Francis Magalona, sinabi ko sa akin po, kailan mamatay si Francis? Sa uling para nakita ko sa media, nawawala na yung buhok, masusunod yan, yung may-ari ng buhok, mawawala. Makakago, di ba? So, according to specific history of radiation in America, anomaly was started. Dr. George Carlo was hired by a certain cellular telephone industry association as CTIA to study the safety of their products, especially the player. So, napag-aralan niya, and he discovered this report na kinakailangan ang mga tao ko ay warningan. Ito po ang tinatawag niyang diagnostic marker on cancer. Ito po siya. Sabi dito, kasi si Dr. Carlo po naglabas ng cellphone radiation. For the more than 120 million Americans and over 500 million people worldwide currently using wireless phones, this thoroughly researched and documented cautionary work is an essential guide. Ito po ay mga around 1993 after that, no? Dr. George Carlo was hired by the cell phone industry in 1993 to study the safety of each product. In 1999, his research funds were not renewed and this industry sought to discredit him. His findings on the dangers posed by the microwave radiation from cell phone, disrupting cardiac pacemakers, one, penetrating the developing skulls of children, two, compromising the blood-brain barrier, three, and number four, and most certainly, the inflicting genetic damage that is a non-diagnostic marker for cancer. Yun po yun. Diagnostic marker for cancer, determined by Dr. George Carlo, Sabi po niya, are given clear voice as Carlo bring his case to the public in this examination of the hard science and the shady politics of reckless high-tech industry, now mired in personal injury and class action litigation. So, nagkaroon po ng clarion call sa America about this diagnostic marker on cancer during 1999, and this kind of book was advised by the authority in America to buy from their bookstore, but banned in the Philippines. Banned po ito sa Philippines. Binili po ito sa California at $14. Banned, kasi makikita mo rito, there is anomaly on cell phone. If you don't know what to do, radio station in America po yan. And this is what we call it, electromagnetic frequency. And the biological effect is cancer, genetic damage, mga changes in your cellular behavior, nervous system, blood-brain barrier will be destroyed. Even other part like cardiovascular, your sleeping quality will be disordered. Your hormone will be disturbed and be imbalanced. Immune system will become weak and low, and it will develop diabetes. And your fertility will be impaired. Even your learning capacity will be impaired. Yung talino mo, masisira. You see? Because of ignorance only. And it's my prayer and hope that this gathering today may give you the proper education how to live with the help of Christ. Okay? Okay?
Amen!
Yan po ay hindi po dapat tago. You must know that because the United Nations, the WHO in particular, in around 2009 of October, binigyan na nilang ang kanilang declaration, but not accepted by the Philippine Government Department of Health. Bakit? May problema rito. Sana wala kayong problema ngayon. Opo, sila may problema. May tinatago sila na ayaw yung malaman. Okay? Cellphone radiation will cause tumor on your brain, glioma, salivary gland, and acoustic nerve tube. Tatlong bukol ang ililikha ng yung cellphone radiation. If you don't know what to do. And even other doctors confirm it could break down your blood-brain barrier, promoting eye cancer and other ear tumor and many other cancer, variety of cancer. And even it damage your blood, genetic damage will be promoted. DNA damage is about also becoming risky, increase the occurrence of your lymphoma or cancer of the colonic, significantly reduce fertility. Mababaw po ang lalaki. Gusto niyo ba ang lalaki mabaw?
Okay.
Ito ang cellphone ninyong hawak, panira ng sperm yan. Yan dito yung aking bag dito, wala akong dalang cellphone. Puro papel, saka konti yung barya. Ang cellphone, nasa bag. Yan, nasa bag. Hindi ko na nilalagay po sa katawan. Baka yung cellphone nyo, lagi nasa katawan. In Japan, ang cellphone, ipapatong nila sa table, mag-usap sila. Eh, dito, hindi mo ipatong kasi baka pagkagin mo, wala na yung cellphone. Di ba? So, kinakailangan, kung hindi mo mayalis ang cellphone sa katawan mo, inom na maraming tubig ng Clistel.
Yeah!
Bakit? Bakit? Iinom. Mamaya, malaman nyo. Dr. Rubik, siya po nag-declare na epidemic card from cellphone. Ito yung mobile phone usage. Wala nang binanggit, walang laptop, walang iba pa. Cellphone particularly because all individuals has a cellphone. Dr. Rubik, a PhD, is an instrumental in helping me the biofield. And that biofield is your body. Yung po si Sarayan po ng radiation through your cellphone. And this is a pathway. The cell phone is the direct action, DNA breakage by radiation through cell phone. Then, the damage has been done. Your DNA cross-linkage is damaged. DNA cross-linkage, The base is lost.